Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to talk about why you shouldn't use vacuum full and how to use the alternative p2epack on Amazon RDS. This is a blog post by depesz on his blog, where he talks about when to use vacuum full, and he says the short answer is never. You should not use vacuum full. Now, for those of you who don't know, vacuum full is essentially a more aggressive form of a regular vacuum. And it's something that Postgres itself would not run on its own. It's something that you would have to run explicitly. People do actually run vacuum full. And as depesz notes here, people put vacuum full calls in things like cron jobs, or they run it manually when they feel it is the right moment. And there really isn't a good moment to run vacuum full. The reason is because it takes an XX exclusive lock for a table. It doesn't just take that for a moment, it takes it for the full time of that vacuum full, which for a large table could be multiple hours. Now, that is a big problem because during that time, nothing else can access a table. No selects, no inserts, no updates, no deletes. This is different from a regular vacuum. Regular vacuum, you can run and the workload can still operate in parallel. This works that way because vacuum full rewrites the whole table and the indexes. And again, that just takes time. The question is, what should I do if I think I have a use case for vacuum full? There are generally two situations that depesz describes here where people think that they need vacuum full. First of all, they think that auto vacuum doesn't handle everything as it should. They think that they have to do better than what auto vacuum is doing. And they have to fix it because auto vacuum missed something and so vacuum full is going to make things better. Second, people have very bloated tables and they want to remove the bloat from the table. They want to run something that actually makes the table smaller, which most of the time a regular vacuum does not. As depesz notes here, if you have an auto vacuum issue, really you should go and try to debug your auto vacuum settings. If auto vacuum does not work for you, what you should do is run a normal vacuum. Some people I know, they run daily vacuums, but they don't run the full vacuum. They just run a regular vacuum at night. And that's not going to lock anything. It's not going to block anything. It's just going to make sure that cleanup work is done consistently when auto vacuum can't trigger things correctly. If you have bloat on a table, which usually would be caused by having an auto vacuum configuration that's not optimal, then there isn't really as easy of a way to fix it. Vacuum full is the only way in core Postgres to really clean things up. Now, pgrepack is a utility you can use that is not part of standard Postgres. You actually have to install it as an extension. And this is something that has been pretty well tested over the years. I've run it myself in a production database without problems, and I've heard many people have good success with it. The main benefit of pgrepack is that it rewrites the table without taking long locks. It doesn't impact production workloads in the same way. As depesz notes, it's pretty amazing. The way it works, the quick version of this is you create the extension, and then you run pgrepack. The challenging part about running pgrepack in the cloud when you have a managed database is that you actually have to install not just the extension, but you also have to install the pgrepack utility. The team at AWS actually wrote about how to do this a little bit over a year ago. This is a somewhat long article, and it just describes the benefits and also says why you shouldn't run vacuum full. And by the way, if you're wondering, do I need this on Aurora? Yes, you do. Bloat can still happen on Aurora. Aurora still has vacuum. There's a reason that AWS made it available for both regular RDS and Aurora. Now, first of all, they create the extension pgrepack, which is fully supported on Amazon RDS and Aurora. Later, they do go through and they say, now you need to have a client machine. If you're used to managed service, you actually have to run pgrepack as a tool. The way you would do this is you would fire up an EC2 instance, and then you would get the pgrepack binary installed, either building it from source or the Postgres Yum repository. This has to be the exact same version of pgrepack. This is challenging because, for example, Amazon RDS doesn't always update to the latest patch release of all the extensions. I was running pgrepack a couple of weeks ago, and I had to go in and use an older version of the pgrepack binary to match what the Amazon RDS database was using. This is something to watch out for. It's going to take some time to get that installed correctly. But once you do, you can run pgrepack against a particular table. It's pretty straightforward. You can also read about the other options here on the pgrepack page. Really, the main option is you give it a table, and then it starts doing its work. You want to make sure that you run this from a long lift connection, so in a screen or tmux session on an EC2 instance, and have that running for like an hour or two, or however long it takes, depending on the size of the table. And to conclude why you would want to do this, personally, I've experienced, we had a table that was 490 gigabytes in size, but then after we ran pgrepec, it was reduced down to just 10 gigabytes. We had over 400 gigabytes of bloat on that table, which ultimately was caused by a combination of some bad update statements throughout multiple weeks and auto vacuum settings not being aggressive enough. pgrepec was the way for us to get back the performance, make that table over 10x smaller. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.